Good morning, everyone. Dakshar, I got message from 2-3 students that Miss don't start till we come. So I was waiting for them and they have joined just now. Only the request which was given by students to me, that's why I was waiting for them. Okay, Aryan, good morning. Good morning, Bitta. Okay, good morning, everyone. Okay, that was the only reason I was waiting for them because I got message from them. Okay. So today we are going to start with natural vegetation and wildlife. Now, on the basis of your CET exam, what things you have to keep in mind when we are doing or preparing for this chapter? That is most important because our main focus is, you should know that our main focus is completely on that how we are going to answer those CET questions and all. Because sometimes it happens that options are given. Because many students have messaged me that, Miss, we understood the concept, but when it comes to options and all, we get little confused and all. Now, here you have to focus on what? First thing is, you have to divide this chapter into four parts, okay? And then you have to club it into natural vegetation of India with wildlife and then natural vegetation of Brazil with wildlife, okay? Now, ICSE students, already you have done the natural vegetation of India. So you must be knowing that various types of forest, what type of forest are there. But here you will find somewhere the comparative study of India and Brazil. And here you have to first focus on that which natural vegetation you will find common in India and Brazil. And according to that, you have to even find it out that related to that type of vegetation or type of forest, which common wildlife also you will find in this particular comparative study. So here we are not only going to focus on dissimilarity, or we are going to compare only to find out the dissimilarity, but we are going to find it out the similarities between two nations. That means which similarities are there, though both are located in extreme locations. That is very, very important. So that is one thing which we are going to focus. Okay, so now first thing which I would like to share with you all is cross profile. You will find the cross profile of Brazil on screen. Now in exam, they may give you this type of diagram and some options, questions and options will be given to you. Now, very important thing is that this cross profile along with physiography, how to read it, how to understand it. Now, first thing, when you will see this, that is somewhere a compact, in compact form, whole detail is given, okay? Right from rainfall, that you can see in blue color, okay? Temperature, height of that particular land, distance is given, type of that physical features are given, and even you will find that latitudinal extent is also given, okay? So you will find that in a small, that cross profile, okay, you will find that physiography divisions are given and vegetation, what type of vegetation, forest they are having according to the temperature and rainfall. So you have to be very careful about this, okay. Now, next thing which I would like to say is that first you will see that most elevated part, okay. Or we can say the highest elevation which you will find in Brazil is Guiana Highlands. Okay, so here you can see it is over here, it is 16. See, the rainfall is given 1600 millimeter, but average height is given 1000 meter. Same way you will find that Amazon basin, which if we have already studied, it's a low-lying area, which is having a height of between 0 to 200 meter height is there. So in Guiana Highlands, you will find tropical forest. In Amazon Basin, equatorial forest. In Parana Basin, you will find deciduous forest. In Brazil Highland, till the extreme southern part or the coastal region, you will find temperate forest. So, and if we'll see it direction-wise, so you will find the northern part, that is the northern part of Brazil, there you will find Sai, you can put your questions in chat box, Bitta. Sai, you can ask questions, Bitta, rather than raising hand, Bitta, I will answer you. Put it in the chat, Bacha. Okay? Now here you will find that tropical forest, right from the northern part till the extreme, that is coastal region towards the south, which we call it as a Brazilian highland, or we can call it as a pampas. Okay, okay, sir. I thought you are asking something, bachcha. Okay. Any question in between you have or doubt you are having, you are going to put it in the chat. I will answer. I will clear your doubt. Okay. Do we need to remember the rainfall and temperature values? Jui, what happens, beta? If suppose we that questions related to climatic condition is asked, and then they ask you to identify the type of forest, or they will give you the type of forest and you have to choose the answer based on rainfall, then you will need this information, Jui. If you have seen the CET book which we have shared with you all, in that you must have seen that this type of diagram is there and some questions and options are there. Jui, are you getting me, beta? So here what happened, you not only have to cross-check this too. Okay, beta? So, and most important thing is that temperature, rainfall and type of forest. These are the three things which you have to remember. Plus the fourth thing which you have to remember, that particular type of forest is found in which particular region. So actually, you know, the brief description about the vegetation, or I must say the forest type in Brazil, it is completely given in this cross profile. Okay. So clearly you can say that Guyana Highlands is having a tropical type forest, or tropical type of forest you will find in the Guyana Highlands. Equator forest, equatorial forest you will find in Amazon Basin, deciduous in Parana, and temperate type of forest you will find in Brazil Highland. And direction also wise, if you see from north to south, you will come to know that how the description is given. Okay. So according to me, I think in your textbook, on the first page of this chapter itself, they have given this cross profile. Go through it thoroughly and you will understand and you will be able to write answers. By the end of this chapter, I have some questions based on this diagram. So you can cross check and you will just analyze that if this type of diagram is given and questions are asked, I'm able to answer or not. That is more important. So from this diagram, definitely it is very important. And questions may come, they may give diagram and they may ask questions, or directly they can ask questions giving options. Next thing, in general, they may ask you that which factors will influence natural vegetation and wildlife of any part of the earth. Okay, so two major things is relief and climate, that you have to remember. Sub that classification, if you'll not remember, it's okay, because everyone knows relief includes land, soil, altitude. And climate, we are having temperature, humidity, photosynthesis, that is a sun rays and all, that is photo period, and precipitation, what type of precipitation takes place. But this too, you have to remember that factors which influence natural vegetation and wildlife is relief and climate. They may ask you. Sometimes they may only give one option. They may give two options. Okay. So you have to choose both, that relief and climate, both they influence, okay, this both these factors influence vegetation and wildlife. Sometimes in option, they give relief and climate, then they give climate, and then they give some fourth option. Students, they always put it that vegetation and wildlife completely, they mostly they write only climate. So be careful, you have to write relief as well as climate, both option. That is more important. Now, very important area wise, first we are going to focus on Brazil vegetation. No doubt we have seen cross profile, but if they give the map and some questions are given, so you should know that physical area, which physical area is having what type of forest. So here, that's why I have taken both the maps together. In your textbook, they have given only types of forest, okay, with wildlife they have given. But if they ask you that which particular region, what type of forest is there, so no doubt that cross profile is going to help you. But along with that, it is very important that you have to remember the map. Okay. Now you will see that major part of Brazil, it is covered by equatorial forest. And which direction also. Okay. That is right from north, northwest till central part of Brazil. You will find over here. So which particular areas it covers. So it covers Guyana Highland, Amazon River Basin, and all this whole part, this you will find it is equatorial forest. Okay. Now, don't get confused in equatorial forest and hot deciduous forest, which is on the coastal region. Here you will find in the eastern coastal region. Eastern coastal region, you will find hot deciduous forest over here and tropical grassland, which we call it as a savanna. And drought area, where we have seen in the previous chapter that rain shadow area is developed due to great escarpment. So this is a thorny scrub which you will find. And the only one very small part or very little that part you will find in the extreme southern part of Brazil, that is a temperate grassland pampas. Okay. And you will see in the physical map also on screen that here you will find pampas. It is a low-lying area, and where you will find in the small part of this pampas, you will find temperate grassland, which we call it as a pampas. So many times related to pampas, they ask you questions, and above all, definitely pamp, that is pantanal, swampy land, one of the largest wetland, okay, of the world, which is there in Brazil, which we call it as a pantanal, swampy land, wetland, okay, which covers Mato Grosso. Okay, so this is what you have to keep in mind, and you have to remember all this thing, okay. So here, when we do comparison, okay, when we do comparison of types of forest in Brazil map with the physical map, so you will understand that how comparison is done and how it helps you to understand better. So mostly I have seen that in MCQ questions, mostly, you know, students, they forget about this last part, okay, the extreme southern part of Brazil, which we call it as a pampas. There we'll get tall grasses, temperate grassland area is there, low-lying area. So if we'll see the physical map, which we have studied in the previous chapter, we compare it, we come to know that what type of forest. Yes, remember there are 6 types of forests found in Brazil, where you will find very small part, very small area is covered by swampy land and temperate grassland. Please remember this too. And the major that area which is covered by forest, that is Brazil forest, equatorial forest in Brazil. Okay, so this is the major part. Remember this thing. Am I clear with you all? Okay, can I get a response in chat, beta? Thank you, Jui. Thank you, Aryan. Thank you, Prajakta, and everyone. If you still have any doubts, students, and you want me, that please explain it again, or particular one topic, if you'll find any confusion is there, please let me know. Okay. Today I'm going to focus only on the basis of that CET exam, that what type of options they may give you and what you have to remember. That I'm going to focus on that. Okay. Now, if we talk about Brazil vegetation, so here the physical map I have given, you will find there are variation. Okay. That is rainfall variation is there because of the various types of physical division, physical features we find. Okay. Now, equatorial region, you will find over here, throughout the year, the rainfall takes place. So in option, they may ask you, okay, there that in which particular part, okay, you will find that throughout the year, rainfall takes place. So it's the equatorial region that you have to remember. As we move away from the equator, everyone knows that this is 0 degree. This is the equator. As we move away from the equator, you will come to know that the rainy days and the amount of rainfall reduces. And this way you will find that there is impact on life cycle of vegetation. So in option, they may ask you that if rainfall reduces, it will affect what? So life cycle of vegetation or wildlife, or they may give that development or any option they give you. Okay, so you have to be careful that as we move away from the equator in Brazil, it affects the life cycle of vegetation. Okay, next you have to remember about the northern part of Brazil. Everyone knows it's an equatorial region, so we know that enough sunlight they receive throughout the year, rainfall is there. So rainfall here maximum is in the northern part of Brazil, that is 2000 millimeters. And temperature is also high, and that's why they get enough sunlight, 28 degree Celsius. And that's why you will find dense forest. See, enough sunlight they get. And second thing, enough water they are getting through precipitation. And both the things help them to grow faster, and that's why dense forest is found in the northern part of Brazil, which we call it as an equatorial region. So equatorial region is a northern part of Brazil. Throughout the year rainfall, that is maximum rainfall 2000 millimeter and temperature 28 degree Celsius. Now, here you will find that there are few regions which receive rainfall only for a certain period. Okay. There you will find that complete the different type of vegetations you will find. The various types of grasses you will find, short shrubs you will find, thorny vegetation according to the amount of rainfall. So as you move away from equator, you will find the amount of rainfall will also reduce. So when you see the cross profile, there you will come to know that as we are moving from the northern to southern part, the amount of rainfall is also decreasing. Okay. So this, that is going to help you. See, I would like to share that screen. See here. It is in tropical forest, okay? Guyana Highland, that is a very small part of Brazil. Only 1600 millimeter rainfall. Equatorial 2000. As we are moving towards the south, so you will find in Parana, 1500 millimeter. Brazilian Highland, 600 millimeter. Then towards the coastal region, you will find that it varies from 1500 to 1200. So somewhere you will find that maximum rainfall takes place in equatorial forest. Am I clear with you all, Vita, this topic? So you have to be very careful when you see that how many types of forest are there. According to the physical map, always open and see physical map is given in your textbook on page number 15. So you can compare with that. Okay. That physically, that what type of features are there, and according to that, what type of forest are found. That is very important. And cross profile is really very helpful for students to answer so many questions. Now, this is one part which is very, very important. They may ask you that which particular part is known as the lungs of the world, why it is called. In short, they may give you options and all. So you should know that evergreen forest, which is the northern part of Brazil, it throughout the year rainfall takes place. Now, because of evergreen rainforest, you will find that when more plants, more vegetation is there, so you will find the level of oxygen is also very high. So they release maximum oxygen and they reduce the level of carbon dioxide. And this is the reason that rainforests are known as lungs of the world. Okay, so they may ask you, so be careful that which particular part is known as the lungs of the world of Brazil. And why, if in short, they give you option. Now, when we compare, no doubt we are going to move to India's forest and vegetation and all. There you will find that whatever the six types of forest we are having, there you will not find one type of forest which India is having, and that is Himalayan forest. So Himalayan forest of India, they will not find in Brazil. Reason, because average elevation of Brazil, Yes, Jude, both are same beta. Even we call it as an evergreen forest, equatorial forest, both are same beta. Okay. Now here you have to keep, what is the reason? Because average height of Brazil is 1000 meters or above, okay? Average, okay? Whereas in India, we are having average height of 8000 meters. So you will not find Himalayan forest because the locations of Himalayas is not over here. And they in Brazil don't have elevation. Okay, they have average height. Highlands they have. They don't have Himalayan mountains and all. They have highlands. And that is the reason. Next thing you will find, that which are the common that forest which India and Brazil is having. That is evergreen, deciduous, thorny shrub. These are the common that forest which you will find in India as well as Brazil. So they may ask you in objective type question, that which common forest India and Brazil is having and which particular forest is not there, which is there in India or which is not there in Brazil. So that you have to keep in mind. Okay. Next thing which you have to keep, that in Brazil, no, you will find a greater diversity vegetation. Reason is that half of the area of Brazil, it is under the equatorial forest, which we call it as an evergreen forest. So because of the particular type of climate, okay, that they have a 28 degree Celsius, that is temperature is there. rainfall is throughout the year, then you will find that sufficient water, okay, because of Amazon River, okay. So these are the reasons that because of which you will find greater diversity vegetation. Not only vegetation, even wildlife, you'll find they have various types of wildlife or insects you will find in Brazil, which you will not find in any part of the world. That is the main thing over here. Now, for your objective type questions, they may ask you that in Pantanal, what do you find? Okay, swampy area, Pantanal. You'll find anacondas, crocodiles, alligators and all, okay, in Brazil. See, I have taken these pictures for you all. So when you remember these pictures, it becomes easy to remember, pictorial form, okay? Then you will find major species of pigs, puma, monkeys, a leopard, okay, that you will find in Brazil, okay? See, remember one thing, when we are talking about the wildlife, now this we are discussing about Brazil. Now, same thing, you will find that there are certain species, certain animals, certain plants which you will find in Brazil and India both. So that also you have to keep in mind when we are doing this. Okay. Now, you will find swordfish, okay, in sea. Pink dolphins and piranhas in various rivers you will find. I think in Amazon River you will find. And these are the real pictures which you will find that really that fish, or we can say the pink dolphins, really they have a pink color. Okay. Aryan is asking for... That is a tamarind, okay, golden tamarind bitter. Golden tamarind bitter. Aryan, okay. Now, these are the birds, okay, which you'll find that main bird is, this is condor, that is, which is huge in size. They fly high in the sky. So they may ask you option giving only the description of that particular bird. So you should know that even other than this, you will find parrots, macaws and flamingos also. Now, as I told you, the millions of insects varieties are found in Brazil. Okay. And all those types of insects which are not found in whole world, those type of species you will find. Miss, can you show the wildlife in Pantanal? Okay, one minute, beta. See here, beta. It's a anaconda, crocodile, and alligators, beta. Okay, so you can remember. Pictures are going to help you to remember, beta. That's why I'm showing you this. I have taken this for you all. Okay, so as I told you, millions of insects varieties are found in Brazil. Now we will come to India. See, this much information is enough for your wildlife and vegetation about the Brazil, I tell you. Okay, beta. Now, there are in vegetation, you will find that various types of vegetation, what type of plants are found and all, that we are going to discuss India ka, what do you say, natural vegetation and all. Along with that, you will come to know that what type of trees are found over there. Okay, and you will find that Pau Brazil is there. Rosewood is there. There are common some trees and some extreme that you'll find that extreme areas and some, we can say the few trees like Pau Brazil, you'll find only in Brazil. And on the basis of that, only the name Brazil is given to this country. Okay. So there are few trees which are found only in Brazil and there are many common trees which you'll find in India and Brazil both. We are going to discuss that in question answer session and even the observe and answer. So that also you will learn along with that. Now after Brazil, I would like to focus on India. Okay. Now in India, you will find that there are five types of this here. You will find tropical thorny vegetation, alpine, Himalayan. Okay. Then you will find tropical, that is moist deciduous, wet evergreen, semi-evergreen and dry deciduous. So in tropical also, you will find the variations over here. Okay. Now, major, if you'll see it as a, over here, you will find that this particular part where you will find the central highland and Deccan part and here, you'll find that major, this, I think in ICSC, we are having that chapter in that also, nice one map is given like this only, which is going to help you a lot to understand the natural vegetation. So when we compare with this, See, Trans Himalayas, it is completely that cold desert you will find. It is covered by snow. Then you will find, go towards the Western Himalayas and all, there you will find alpine and you will find Himalayan moist temperate. Okay, according to the height you will find. See, the height or the altitude of that particular area in Himalayas, you will find that according to the height, that Shivalik range, then you will find lesser, greater and trans. Accordingly, you will find the vegetation also varies in Himalayas. So you have to keep in mind this, that as the altitude increases, the type of vegetation also varies in Himalayas. And when we talk about the hot desert, okay, you will find over here that in hot desert, completely you will find that tropical moist deciduous, or we can say the tropical thorny vegetation. Both you will find hot desert, and here see Rajasthan, some part of Rajasthan, and you will find in Gujarat also. Okay, so that is a thorny vegetation you will find over here. Hot desert, you will find over here in hot desert, that is tropical moist deciduous, okay, where you will find that hardly some types of that crops are found, not even crops, I will say, vegetation like acacia and cacti or babool and all, where the leaves, the amount of leaves are less, stunted trees are there, that type of trees you will find over here. Same way you will find that in Deccan, that is peninsula, okay, central highland Deccan, that also you will find tropical dry deciduous, and here you will find that subtropical that is tropical thorny vegetation in the central part of Maharashtra, which is known as, see here, central part of Maharashtra, and here in central highland, here also you will find subtropical or tropical thorny vegetation type. So according to this, see, these maps are going to help you to understand that which particular region, see the name of the region is given and type of forest is given. So it becomes easy for you to understand. So if in, suppose in option they give you type of area and they give option of forest, type of forest. So both you can compare it. So that's why both the maps I have taken together. So that you also, you can learn it, and it, a map is given in your textbook also. Please do refer that, okay, before your ICT, geography ICT. Now, if you talk about the five major types of forest in India, so we are having evergreen, deciduous, thorny, coastal and Himalayan. Okay, so this you will find. Himalayan you will not find in Brazil, okay. You will find coastal, you will find deciduous, evergreen, thorny, this all you will find. But you will not find Himalayan forest in Brazil. Okay. Now, one by one, we are going to see this also. Now, when we talk about this five, which are given in your textbook, tropical, evergreen, deciduous, then mountain, that is mountainous forest, mangrove, which is on the coastal region, and tropical thorn forest, where scanty rainfall takes place. If you just understand, okay, rainfall, wherever the rainfall is very high, evergreen. Where average rainfall, deciduous forest. One question they may ask you, that which particular type of forest is found in high amount or major area is covered by which particular type of forest in India. So it's a tropical deciduous forest, which you can see right from here, that is Haryana-Punjab border, you will find, except this desert area, major part of India, it is covered by tropical deciduous forest. See here, green color. Deciduous, major part of India, it is covered by deciduous forest. So you have to keep in mind this thing. Everyone understood? Okay, I hope this will help you to find it out the answers. Okay, in options of this. See this particular part, very easy. Thorny forest, where the less rainfall takes place. And remember one thing, students know, they only remember that Rajasthan is having a thorny type of a forest, okay, that is tropical thorn forest. No, my dear, area which is having a scanty rainfall, or we can say the rain shadow region in Deccan Plateau, which you will find over here, it's central part of Maharashtra, which extends towards the Andhra Pradesh. See this particular part, this is also having a thorny type of forest. Students, only keep in mind Rajasthan and some part of Gujarat. Please don't forget that in Deccan Plateau, we are having rain shadow region, where you will find this tropical thorny type of forest. Please be careful about it. So there are the two areas, okay, where you will find the thorny type of forest. Okay, now evergreen forest, main part, that is the key terms which you have to remember along with the pictures also. I can show you the pictures also. First thing is amount of rainfall, that is 2000 millimeter, okay, ample sunlight. They are tall, they are dark green and dense, broad leaves, okay, and their wood is hard and durable, okay. You will find many creepers. They are also grow from the ground level, and they get connected to this dense trees and all. Biodiversity you will find is very high, and this type of forest you will find in Western Ghats, Northeastern region, Andaman and Nicobar. So which trees, now this you will help you in your Brazil also. Evergreen trees, mahogany, rosewood and rubber, these are the common trees which you will find in Brazil also and India also. Please be careful. So which trees are found and what type of wood it is? It is hard and durable. So these are the keywords which you have to remember. Okay, next we will move to deciduous forest. Now deciduous forest, everyone knows they shade their leaves. Deciduous means shading leaves. Okay, amount of rainfall between 1000 to 2000. Okay, they shade leaves in summer and they regrow in monsoon. Okay, so that is one thing, and this process or this type of feature when you find in particular type of forest, they are known as monsoon forest because they grow in monsoon season, and that's why we call it as a monsoon forest. So which particular type of forest is known as monsoon forest? Deciduous forest. Okay, and in India, where you will find this? You will find in West Bengal, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, okay, Western Ghats, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Kerala. And what type of plants you will find in deciduous? Teak, bamboo, sandalwood and banyan. Okay, next you will find that thorny, it's a thorny shrubs, okay. So here you will find when the rainfall is very less. See the pictures over here. Less than 500 millimeter. So thorny shrub, Rajasthan, some part of Gujarat and rain shadow region of Deccan Plateau. That is a central part of Maharashtra and it is extended towards Andhra Pradesh. Don't forget that. Not only Rajasthan or some part of Gujarat, but central part or the rain shadow region of Maharashtra or Deccan Plateau. Okay, I'm repeating this again and again. So here you will find acacia, bear, catechu, khejri, aloe vera. You will find, see, your leaves are very less. Okay, and somewhere you will find a dry type of nature or the feature you will find over here. You will not find greenery over here. Okay, and they are stunted trees. Okay, catechu you will find, but here also you will find that hardly few leaves are there. Okay, so number of leaves are very less in thorny shrubs, and it's a stunted, as if somebody has stopped the growth of that, or they have cut down the growth of that particular reason. So that is one thing. Okay, coastal forest, here you will find coastal vegetation. This you will find in swampy areas, that is western coastal region, eastern coastal region. Okay, estuaries are there, lagoons are there, where saline soil is there. Humidity is there, moist climate is there. And in India, we call it as a mangroves or Sundarbans. Okay. And don't forget that Sundarbans, which we call it as the largest delta in the world, Ganga Brahmaputra Delta, which is the largest mangrove forest in the world also. Okay. So all these names we have to remember. That is Ganga Brahmaputra Delta, Sundarbans, largest mangrove forest, fan-shaped mangroves in the world. Okay, so it seems to be like a fan. Okay, the shape of that particular Ganga Brahmaputra Delta is like a fan. So we call it as a fan-shaped largest delta. So that the various names are given. Okay, now coastal forest, whatever the trees they grow, their wood of those trees is oily, very light, but durable. Okay, and mainly you'll find in eastern coastal and even western coastal also you'll find. Western coastal, we are having estuaries, okay, and mangroves you will find on the coastal region, mostly in the eastern, some part of the western you will find mangroves are there, okay, lagoons, okay, those are estuaries, and the estuaries means what? When the fresh water of river and saline water of any oceanic or sea body, when they come and meet at one particular point, okay, and the depression, that in that depression, the, both the water get accumulated, estuaries, and this also forms on the coastal region. And lagoons, everyone knows, it is on the rocky coast where the depression is there and water get accumulated. Okay, it is separate from the main water body. So there also you will find. And we, I think mangroves, everyone has seen, I think on the back road of this in orbit, back road of Andheri, everywhere you will find this type of mangroves are there. Okay, so these are the coastal forests. Now Himalayan forest. Here you will find that one table also I have taken for you all, that according to the height you will find, according to the height you will find that the types of vegetation differs in Himalayas. Now climate, everyone knows that mostly in Himalayas it is very cold, okay, and altitude in, that is, increases with the temperature, as we go towards the high altitude the temperature decreases, okay. Now you will find in Jammu and Kashmir and some part of Himalayas temperature goes in minus 40 degrees Celsius, and Trans Himalayas it is completely covered by the snow throughout, the snow capped area we call it. Okay, that is that. So very few species of plants can survive in extreme cold condition. So you will find that seasonal flowers you will find, okay, or some type of particular type. Yes, Shravani, you can write your doubts in chat beta, okay, rather than raising hand beta, you can put your doubt in chat bacha. Okay, now Himalayan forest, okay, you will find according to height, you know, the types of vegetation changes, and that's why this table I have put for you all. That Himalayan forest, actually it starts from Jammu and Kashmir till Purvanchal, that is in Arunachal Pradesh, extreme east. Okay. Now, according to the height, you will find foothills, which we call it as a Shivalik range and all. There you will find mixed forest. You find coniferous also, deciduous like sal and all. Okay. In medium altitude, which we call it as a lesser Himalayas and that particular area, there you will find that the height is still 4,500 meters. There you will find coniferous trees like pine, deodar, fir and all. And as you go highest Trans Himalayas and all, which is covered by snow throughout the year, there you will find that seasonal flowering trees you will find. You will not find any major type of trees over here because it is covered by snow throughout the year. So this you have to keep in mind, that in Himalayan forest, vegetation varies according to the altitude of that particular area. So it is divided into three parts. Foothills, then you will find the height till 4,500 meters, and then above 4,000 meter till 8,000 or 8,000 plus meters. Okay, so there you will find that it varies. So Himalayan forest, in option they may ask you, it is divided into three parts. Okay, that is the highest altitude, medium altitude and foothills. So Shivalik, lesser Himalayas, and from greater to Trans Himalayas. This way we have divided. So this you have to keep in mind. So this, see here, pictures over here. See this type of flowers you will find in the extreme height and all. Sal trees for deodar, pine, this type of trees you will find. Now, wildlife, very important you have to remember. There is one match the following also, okay, that name of the animals are given and they have described the area, okay, maybe feature they have given, climatic condition they have given, or they may have given any state or region. So you should know, you should be able to match it properly. If you have seen in CET book, which is shared in group and all, you will find three column match the following is also there. That, so that way also they have to, you have to make a link. That means you have to link all the three options having a same feature. So that also you should know. So here they may ask you area also, climate also, and the name of the elephant, or they may ask you name of animal, vegetation and region. So you should know how to link all this thing. Okay, so elephants, you have to remember, hot and humid forest you will find, that is mostly in the south. Okay, Then one horn rhinoceros you will find in swampy marshland, that is Assam. Wild ash and camels, desert area or arid land like Rann of Kutch in Gujarat or Great Indian Desert in Rajasthan. Snow leopard and yak, you will find snow-capped regions of Himalayas like Trans-Himalayas, Karakoram Range, Greater Himalayas, which we call it as a Himachal. Okay, so this all words which I'm saying, those words they may give you to connect. Okay, like snow-capped region means which region? It is Trans-Himalayas, Karakoram Range, or we can say Greater Himalayas or Himadri. Okay, all these are snow-capped regions in Himalayas. So you have to connect it with them. Peninsular region, that is a complete Deccan Plateau and Madhya Pradesh, Central Highland and all. There you will find Indian bison. Okay, you will find black buck, antelope and favorite monkeys, snakes, that is reptiles and all that you will find in peninsular regions. Okay, now India is the only country in the world where both lions and tigers are found. Otherwise you will find, you just see any part of the world, either you will find lions or you will find tigers, you will not find both. So you have to keep in mind that India is the only country where lion and tigers both are found. Okay, so it's something, a special feature about India. Okay, now very important part here, you will come to know that here you will see the key, the legend is given, and the miniature drawing of all animals are given. Now what you have to do, this I will give you at the end, you have to write that suppose a lion is there, so write lion, and seeing this picture you should know the name of the states and all. Okay, so in which particular area you will find lions? So I can say that it is in Gujarat. Okay, you will find in Rajasthan. Okay, you will find in some part, that is some part of Madhya Pradesh. Okay, so you can see the miniature drawing. Here you will find it is in Jharkhand. Okay, where else you can see lion? Only this one. So this is going to help you to answer the objective type questions or MCQ questions, okay, which is going to help you to understand and to name the states, that which states, what type of animals are found. Because sometimes they are going to give you the map, and from map you have to answer that particular, they may give you particular animal and you have to name the region or the state. Okay, sometimes it happens that you have to tell only the northern part of particular state or southern part of particular state. If I just say crocodile, so I can't say Maharashtra. See, you will find that alligator or crocodile over here. Okay, this is crocodile. So you can't say that crocodile in Maharashtra. I have to say that western coastal region, or we can say the Konkan. This is a Konkan area, coastal region. Here Lakshadweep. Here you will find that Coromandel coast. Here to everywhere you will find Coromandel coast, northern Sircas, or we can say overall eastern coastal region. If I talk about the tortoise, okay, or turtles and all, see Olive Ridley turtles. So here you will find it is given only in one particular region, that is eastern coastal region, but only towards the Odisha. So that also you have to be very careful. See, Odisha is given. So here I have not named the states and all, only the picture, miniature drawing of the animals are given over here. But you should know the name of the states, which is going to help. And that's why we always teach you states of that particular country when we start with 10th standard, maybe ICSE or SSC. Okay, because that is the base. Now here also you will come to know that if you have studied and you have just you remember all the states and all, it becomes easy for you to identify if this map is given. So you can easily identify that which particular state is having what type of animals. That is very, very important. Okay, this is a differentiate between. Only thing you have to remember, that is flora and fauna. It's very simple. Okay, flora, it is completely related to plant kingdom. And fauna means it is completely related to the animals. Okay, that's a very simple thing. Okay, so India is having 47,000 of different species of plants and 89,000 different species of animals. That is the only thing, flora and fauna. Now here some match the followings are given. Okay. Now I want you all to do this, and if you can answer in chat fast, you can do. Because after this, I am going to give you few questions which you all are going to write on your own. So I will come to know, and you will write answer over there, and then we will discuss those answers. Okay. Now here you will find, okay, evergreen forest. Okay. Now I will already shared answers, so you must be knowing. So evergreen forest. So evergreen forest. If you see all these options, you will find in the Western Ghat also evergreen forest. Some part of the India you will find that Western Ghats. Deciduous forest you will find in Madhya Pradesh. Thorny shrubs you will find in Gujarat. Okay. Himalayan forest you will find in Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. Coastal forest you will find in Sundarbans. Okay. Now your students may get confused that thorny shrubs, why it is not given as a hot desert in Rajasthan, why it is given Gujarat. The second question arises, Himalayan forest, why they have given Himalayan forest as Arunachal Pradesh and they have not given cold desert in Jammu and Kashmir? Because cold desert in Jammu and Kashmir, we don't have any major forest. Remember one thing, we have only flowers. Okay, that's why Himalayan forest, be careful that Himalayas are in Arunachal Pradesh also and cold desert in Jammu and Kashmir, but Himalayan forest you will not find in cold desert, but you will find in Arunachal Pradesh. Same with thorny shrubs. In hot desert, if you just see the map, I would like to show the map. Okay. Just going to help you to understand. See the pot to make you all confused. Okay. You will find, see a desert area. It is thorny. Okay, desert over here, they have given. Only desert you can't see. See, Gujarat is having major thorny forest. Okay, here also you will find. See, hot desert, no, remember one thing. Hot desert area. It is, actually it is a tropical moist deciduous. Somewhere it is connected, somewhere very close to, see here Indus River is there, the tributaries are there. And here you will find that Arabian Sea over here. So here you will find hot desert. It is having a moist deciduous. And this particular part is having a thorny vegetation. Gujarat and here. So don't get confused in this. Okay. See. So whenever I give this match the following students, they get confused over here. So be careful about it. Okay. Now next one. Next one, I don't want to show you the answers. I want you all to give this answers in chat box. Try this. I want you all to do this. This is related to Brazil. Observe the map of Brazil and give me this answer. And we will discuss this. Everyone. Right answers, beta. Just try. At least try, you all try. Very good. Many students. See, I can see Soham has written all answers. Very good. Okay, Jitesh has given all answer. Very good. Aryan, Vedant, very good, Vedika, Jitesh 5 is E. Okay, here I can see Shivam is also giving answer. Anaga, very good. Arya, all five answers you gave. Very good. Okay, shall we discuss now? Achha, Anaga is giving. I'll wait for you, beta. Shambhavi, very good, beta. You have directly given the answers. Okay. Saurabh, Kausubh. Okay. Shall we now discuss, beta? Let's see your answers are right or wrong. Equatorial forest, Amazon River basin, okay. Grassland, it is pampas. Oh, many students are right. Few have written, okay. You have written Pantanal. Please, Pantanal is swampy land, beta. Swampy land is Pantanal. Or deciduous forest, it is escarpment. And thorny shrub, you will find in Katinga, which is a rain shadow region. Okay, that is extreme eastern part of Brazil, Katinga. Okay, no problem if you have given. Savanna, why you have written thorny shrub savanna? But on what basis you have written savanna? Thorny shrubs, how come savanna, beta? It's a Katinga area, na beta? Okay. So be careful. I think Jui has written correct answer. That is A. Even Jui has written Kaustubh last answer. Many students have written savanna, I can see. So be careful, beta. This type of question discussion, when savanna is not there in Brazil, right? Correct. Okay. We will see that map, Jitesh. We will clear this doubt, beta. Shall we clear this doubt that what type of forest are there in India and Brazil? Again, we will see the map. In India, it is not there, Jitesh. Savanna is not there in India, beta. Here you can't see. Okay. But if you see in Brazil, Jitesh, that's why I'm showing you map, beta. Let's see the map. Okay, what is Jitesh? I think we will see the textbook. No, in textbook also it is given. Okay. I'll open textbook and I will show you better. Just hold on. So that doubt should get clear about the savanna. Okay. Everyone should know the map. I hope everyone is having textbook. So from that also you will come. Savanna is in Brazil, beta. It is there. Savanna is what, beta? Savanna is actually, no, it is a hot deciduous forest. Or we can say savanna somewhere very close to tropical grassland also. Okay, tropical grassland. Mostly that mixture of deciduous plus tropical grassland. That is savanna. If you just see that. Okay, so that is one thing. So here also you will come to know. See, here it is given. See this part. See here, savanna. Can you see, beta? Jitesh, savanna is there in Brazil, beta. Okay. But somewhere you will find it is a like a tropical grassland. Okay, Jitesh. See, cuttinga, this particular part. This is a golden quadrilateral. That is a rain shadow region. And it is in the eastern part of Brazil, cuttinga. Okay, so this way, if you remember map, no, it helps you to understand better. Ah, it's okay, okay, Jitesh. Jitesh, you are doing this SSC ka book beta. Okay, and then also you are answering. That is the best part, bacha. No problem with it. Okay. Now, shall we move to next part, beta? Let me check that you all have understood or not. Okay. And I think sir has already shared that you will get this recording and all, which is going to help you to understand whatever we have taught you. Now, the last part of the chapter is that what the problems are faced by Brazil and India. See, this type of diagram will be given. Okay. And this type of questions may come and then options they may give you. Can you all see, Vita? See, this type of cross profile is given. Okay. Where you will find the physiography is there, natural vegetation is there, and wildlife is there. Okay. And here you can see the questions. Okay. You just observe this and you will come to know that what type of questions are asked over here. Yes, Prince, they may ask you for this also, MCQ also, beta. No, they will give you picture and they will ask you. If you see the CET book, which is shared in group, beta. Okay, in that you must have seen. See, in CET book, it is given, beta. Pictures are given and then below that the question they give and they give option. So from that you come to know, beta. Prince, got it, beta? Yeah, they will give picture. In CET, that book, you will find that picture is given. And then they may ask you, how many millimeter of rainfall does tropical, or they will give dash amount of rainfall is found in tropical forest. And they will give you 4-5. 1 mark only. What they will do, beta? Picture they will give. One question for 1 mark, beta. Then they may give you second question. Kushi, okay, okay. You want acha PDF of textbook. Okay, Kushi, I will send. See what they will do. They will give you one, this type of picture. Okay, they will give you question and then 4 options will be given to you. Okay, same way they may give you a second question based on this diagram only. Okay. Got it, everyone? See, one more question I would like to show you. See, based on this map, which is there in the textbook, they may give you question like this, beta. Am I audible now? I was going on. Okay. Okay, I was telling that this type of question they may. Stop. Okay. So remember one thing, that this type of diagram they may give you better, and they may ask you also that even questions related to temperature, questions related to, you will find even the climatic condition, that where you will find that major low climatic condition or vegetation or rainfall. And I have seen that sometimes they give you the questions based on rainfall mostly. Now here also you will find, see here, which forests are found in western snow-capped region. So seeing this diagram easily you can see, okay, western snow-capped area. So here you will find it's a cold desert, okay. So cold desert, what? Himalayan type of forest. See, this is a gray color. It's a cold desert. In western you will find over here it is Himalayan forest. Yes, Roka, I'm going to show you that also better. Don't worry, I will show you that also. These are all objective type questions, beta, which we will do revision. And this I want to give you. Okay, this is also I want to give you. See, tables are going to help you to learn all objective type questions and all. Now the last part of the chapter here, see the major problem, that many species, which is a part, very important part of this chapter, wildlife, they are on the verge of extinction in India and Brazil both. Major problem is poaching, that we call it as hunting, pollution, deforestation, and which animals are on the verge of extinction. It is Nilgiri, black buck, cheetah, okay. And you will find that not only elephants, you will find that cheetahs are also there, which are really harmless. See, Roka. Jitesh, you were asking about the Roka. See, complete information over here it is. Okay. What is Roka? Okay. Roka is what? It is one type of activity done by the farmers where rather than digging and removing that weeds and dry grass and all, they burn on the field. Okay. Actually, which is not good. Okay. Which is not good for the fertility or the quality of the that land and all. So here you will find that agricultural practice is done like this, and mostly you will find in northern India, Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, and this time too I think strictly they have told not to do Roka, but then also this farmers, they have done it, and mostly you will find in northeast and north country also you will find a lot. Okay. So Roka you will find in northeast part of India, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Mizoram, that is seven sisters. Okay. Remember seven sisters. Then Kerala, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Western Ghats, Madhya Pradesh, Himalayan regions. Okay. And different names they have given to this activity of Roka. See, we call it as a zoom cultivation also. Okay. And mostly you will find in the seven sisters, and even Haryana, Punjab, some areas they do this Roka, that is burning of that weeds or dry grass on the land, and they just spread that ash on that field and then they start cultivating the next crop, that is known as Roka, which is not good for cultivating, for quality of what we say soil or the quality of land. The degradation takes place slowly and gradually. After 5 and 7 years you will come to know that that particular land is converted into, it is completely converted into we can say barren land, or land will be not used for agricultural activity, and they may use it only for the horticulture or some other type of activities. That is what. So Roka you should know, beta. So this is what the Roka is. Okay. And you should know that with the help of map also you should know that majorly it is done where. Okay, in this particular seven sisters include, and Sikkim, including Sikkim and seven sisters, you will find major latest. okay, except Tripura. Tripura, they don't do so much. So that is one thing, okay. And you should know the reasons also, what type of problems are faced related to wildlife and problems faced related to vegetation, that is Roka, which is given on page number 37, as Jitesh told. Okay. Now, when we know that wildlife, okay, it is at the urge of extinct certain things. So government has taken certain steps, okay, which animals are on verge of extinction. So, bacha, major, I just told you, I showed you picture also. Remember this picture? See, it is, okay, you will find it is Nilgiri Thar, Blackbuck, Lion-tailed Macaw, okay, Cheetah, and elephants in certain areas, okay. This is actually the picture related to poaching, that is hunting, how they do hunting and all. Okay, so that is one thing. Got it, everyone, bita? Okay, so which animals are on the verge of extinct? And second thing, you will come to know what are the reasons, okay, why wildlife are on the verge of extinction. Sometimes they may give an option, the word poaching, which is there in the textbook. That is the meaning is hunting. Okay, so hunting, pollution, deforestation, and these are the animals which are on the verge of extinct. I mean, elephants are on the verge of extinct. Okay, that is one thing. And what steps are taken by the government? Okay, so Project Tiger, Project Elephant, okay, and it was started, Project Elephant, in 1992, because in the at the end of the chapter they have asked to find out all these things, so that you have to remember. Even you will find that biosphere reserves are there, okay, which are started by the government. Wildlife sanctuaries are there, national parks are there. All the steps are taken by the government, and you know that Wildlife Week is celebrated in from 2nd October to 8th October. It is not a part of it. Only in the chapter they have given that find out the information related to wildlife, how we protect, how government has taken the steps, okay, what certain things are done as a precautionary step for the animals by the government, and also that Project Tiger, Project Elephant, that you can end. And what measures we have taken to conserve wildlife and forest in India. So all together, that flora and fauna, okay, these are the 5 points which we have to keep in mind. Okay, any of this they may give you, okay, like in options and all, okay, so that you can choose the right one, because options they can give anything. So sometimes they give certain options where they add certain points which is not relevant to this particular thing. So that time you can do. Got it, everyone? Okay, so you have to remember this. That is the one thing which you have to keep in mind. Okay, now we will come to the objective type questions, which are very, very important for you. Okay, and what type of questions they may ask you, and there are certain tables which you have to keep in mind. Okay, one small. See, this is one thing you have to keep in mind. Okay, that is tropical forest. Okay. So, which features? It is given in your textbook. So, if it is given in textbook, so possibility they may ask you. Okay, so you should know these answers and all. So, in short, if they ask you the comparison of India and Brazil related to these 5 types of, what we say, forest and all. See, savanna, Jitesh, you were saying that in India, no, tarai grassland is the only one area, okay, where you will find it savanna, very small part of India. Otherwise, major savanna you will find in Brazil, okay? So, mixed type of vegetation, northern plains you will find, Parana basin you will find, grassland, Shola grassland and pampas. Shola grassland, which is there in the northern part, okay, where low-lying area, there you will find this Shola grassland in a very small part of India. So, these are the things which you have to keep in mind, okay? that is tropical forest, Western Ghats, semi-arid Deccan plateau, okay, savanna, and then tropical. So here you will find that features are given, plus you will find the areas are also given. Comparison of India and Brazil, like where it is found. So it is very important. And when we talk about the forest, okay, we do the comparison of India and Brazil. Okay, there are few things which you have to keep in mind. One thing is that evergreen forest, okay, in Brazil you will find in Amazon river basin. But in India, you will find it is spread across, okay, like in some part of Western Ghats, in North and East. It is not in one huge part, but it is small, small patches you will find. Okay, Brazil does not have any coastal forest, okay, and India has Himalayan as well as coastal forest. So which forest is found in Brazil and which is not found in India and Brazil, which are uncommon and common, that you should know. And in India, you will find only 19% of area is covered by forest, whereas in Brazil, it is 23%. So this is how the difference is given, which you have to keep in mind. Okay. Now I want to give you this, which I want you all to do it. And please write in the chat. Okay. I hope both will be seen. Can you see this evergreen forest? Okay, so this last option, sal, can be seen. Okay, so please, the last option over here is also sal. I want you all to write the first, the answers of this first give reason. First melt the following. Let me check. You all have understood related to animals. Okay, animals, and you will find the feature of that particular region. Here you will find types of forest and what type of trees are. Come on, put it in the chat. Let me check you all have understood or not. Fast. Try to sort out this. Which trees are found? Okay, in which type of forest? Yes, Velisa star. Yes, yes, beta. You all right answer, bacha. Vedika, I'm waiting here. Screen is seen by you all, na? You are able to see the screen, beta? Oh, wait. I have stopped sharing screen. 1 minute, beta. Now you all can see. Okay, so I got. Okay, now can we discuss, Beta, first one? What is evergreen forest? I think maximum students have written evergreen forest. Pau Brasilia. Deciduous forest. One minute, let me check. Okay. Deciduous forest, it's a tick. Okay. Coastal forest, Sundar trees. Himalayan forest, pine, thorny and bush type, khejri. Okay. Now we will see this column. Okay, yaks are found in. Yaks, a polar animal, correct. Okay, rhinosaurs, swampy marshy, correct, beta. Anacondas, anacondas, pantanal, yes. Elephants, hot and humid forest. An antelope, antelope. Peninsular region, correct, my dear. Okay, so see overall, just I'll come back to you now. I'll stop sharing. I would like to tell you one thing from this chapter. No, very important thing is that if you have a textbook, I think everyone is having, those who are not having, definitely I think 2-3 students have told me that you just share the PDF. You all are going to refer the maps, cross profile map, which is showing your wildlife plus type of vegetation. Maximum questions are going to come based on this maps only. You'll just see. And then you should know that what is ROCA and what steps are taken by the government to conserve wildlife and to save this vegetation. And very important thing is that similarities and dissimilarities you should know about India and Brazil. Maybe related to vegetation, maybe related to your wildlife. So which particular common animals are found in both the countries, or in which particular animal is not found in India, but it is found in Brazil, or found in Brazil and not found in India. Okay, so that is very, very important. So students, all the best. And I'm going to share questions with you all in group, beta. PDF also I will share, so you will be able to revise what I taught you today. Okay, God bless you all, and here I end my this session. Okay, bye bye everyone. God bless you all.